A very good morning, students. How are you all? I hope you all are taking a good care of yourself. So, children, let us start today's mathematics class. This is class 10th, subject mathematics, chapter number 11, constructions. Children, as you know that we have completed this chapter now. So, this is the summary lecture of this chapter number 11, constructions. So children, the topics which I am going to cover today, they are, number one, I will make you understand how to divide a given line segment internally in the given ratio. And after that, I will make you understand how to construct the tangents to a circle. So children, let us start today's class. So to make you understand the very first topic, that is division of a line segment internally in the given ratio. For that, I am going to take the very first question from exercise 11.1. So let us start. What is the question's statement? Please listen to the statement carefully. Draw a line segment of length 7.6 centimeter and divide it in the given ratio, that is 5:8. Measure the two parts also. So children, while understanding the question, you may have understood that what is the demand of the question. First of all, we are just going to draw a line segment AB of 7.6 centimeter. So children, this I have drawn using scale. You can see that this is a line segment AB of measurement 7.6 centimeter. Correct? Now children, what would be the next step? We are just going to draw a ray AX while making an acute angle BAX with the line segment AB. Okay. So I am just going to use the compass. What we are supposed to do? I am just going to draw an acute angle. So for that, first of all, an arc is drawn. You can see here. So here I have just drawn one arc. Okay. As I have told you that I am just going to draw one acute angle. So children, I am going to draw the angle of 60 degree. So let us draw a ray AX. Fine. Here you can give the name also X. This is ray AX. So what I have done, I have just drawn a ray, fine, while forming an acute angle, that is BAX, and it is of 60 degree. Now children, as you know that we are just going to divide the given line segment in the ratio. What is the ratio given? Given ratio is 5:8. So you are just going to calculate sum of ratio for this. What would be sum of ratio? That is 5 plus 8 must be equal to 13. So children, what we are supposed to do? We are just going to mark total 13 arcs on this ray AX. This would be our next step of construction. Make sure all the arcs must be equal in length. Means how? See, for example, I have just opened the compass now. Okay. I am just going to draw 13 total arcs. This is arc number 1. While placing it on arc number 2, means the gap between two arcs must be same. This is arc number 3, arc 4, arc number 5, arc number 6. So children, these are total 13 arcs. Let us count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So let us give them the name as, this is A1. A2, A3, A4, A5, A6, A7, A8, A9, A10, A11, A12, and of course the last arc will be A13. What did I say that while opening the compass, okay, of any suitable radius, you are just going to draw the equal arcs. How equal? Means the gap between the arcs must be same. Like A1 must be equal to A1A2. A1A2 must be equal to A2A3. That must be equal to A3A4 and so on. Understood? Now, children, what would be the next step? You are just going to join the last arc with the second point of the line segment, that is point B. I am just going to join them. Here you can see that A13 is joined with point B. Now, children, listen, what would be the next step? From A5, draw A5O, which is parallel to A13B. Okay. By making an angle at A5 that must be equal to A13B. Fine. So what I am going to draw? First of all, I am going to draw an arc on point A13 of any suitable radius. Now, children, you can see that I am just going to draw an arc at point A13. Fine. Then using the same compass, I am just going to draw the arc at point A5 as well. Why did I choose A5? That you know. Why? Because I am going to. Okay, I am just going to draw this arc. You can see, children. Fine. With the same radius. Now, whatever angle is formed at A13B, just measure that angle. You can see. I am just going to measure this smaller angle. From here to here, okay. After measuring it, while keeping it on one part of the arc, I am just going to draw one arc. Okay, placed here, and one arc is drawn. This angle, which I am going to draw now, draw the line from here to here. Okay, you can give the name over here. Let it be point O. So, angle OA5A must be equal to BA13A. This is BA13A. Clear, children? So, angle AA5O must be equal to AA13B. So, here you have observed that A5O is parallel to A13B. Now you may be having a question in your mind that why they both are parallel. Because, children, they both are corresponding angles. As corresponding angles are equal, then we can say that the lines are parallel. These both are parallel lines. And here AX ray is enacting like a transversal. Okay, AA5O is equal to AA13B. So the corresponding angles are equal. It means the lines are parallel. Now, children, as we have been asked to divide this line segment in the ratio 5:8, so let us check. From A to A5 if I reach, so there are total 5, and A5 to A13 if I reach, then there are total 8 steps. Okay, so here you can see that point O is the point which is going to divide the line segment AB in the ratio 5:8. So can I write that AO ratio OB must be equal to 5:8. So this is AO ratio OB is equal to 5:8. Let us go for its justification. Justification of the same construction. What we are going to do, children, here you can see that while making the corresponding angles equal, I can say that A5O is parallel to A13B. So the very first step I am going to write that A5O is parallel to A13B. In which triangle? You can specify triangle in triangle AA13B. Okay. As this line is parallel to this in the bigger triangle, so by basic proportionality theorem, I can say that AO upon OB must be equal to AA5 upon A5A13. Correct? So, by BPT, we can say that AO upon OB is equal to AA5 upon AA5, that is A5A13. Correct? And children, by construction, we know that AA5 upon A5A13 is 5/8. So, can I write it equal to 5/8? So what does it imply? So we can say that AO upon OB is equal to 5 by 8. It implies to AO ratio OB must be equal to 5 ratio 8. Now children, we have been asked that when this complete line segment is divided into two parts in the ratio 5 ratio 8, then we have been asked to come to know about their measurement as well. So when I measured this AO using scale, I have observed that this is equal to 2.9. Okay, and when I observed point, this line segment OB, I have observed that this is equal to 4.7 centimeter. Now children, I am going to switch to the next topic, that is construction of tangents to a circle. Construction of tangents to a circle. So children, as I have already told you that tangent to a circle is a line which touches the circle exactly at one point, and that point is known as point of contact. And we know that radius is perpendicular to the tangent at the point of contact as well, right? From an external point to a circle, two tangents can be drawn. Okay, and here you can see that point Q as well as point R, they both are known as the point of contact, and radius is perpendicular to the tangent at the point of contact. Understood? And suppose this is a circle and you have been asked to draw a tangent from the internal point. Suppose this point is internal point, let it be point P. Draw a tangent to the circle. So no tangent can be drawn when the point lie interior of the circle. Or for case number 3, when the point lie on the circumference of the circle, then one tangent can be drawn. Here you can draw one tangent. Okay, this is center point, and you know that radius is perpendicular to the tangent at the point of contact. Here A is the point of contact. Now children, for construction of tangent to a circle, I am going to take the questions from exercise 11.2. What is the statement of question number 1? Please listen the statement carefully. Draw a circle of radius 6 cm from a point 10 cm away from its center. Construct the pair of tangents to the circle and measure their length. Children, as you know that whenever from an external point two tangents are drawn to the circle, that you know, the length of the tangents are always equal. So here we can say that PQ is equal to PR. So while listening the statement, you may have understood that first of all, we are just going to draw a circle of radius 6 cm. So this I am going to observe and measuring and opening the compass of radius equal to 6 cm. So children, here you can see that I have drawn a circle of radius 6 cm. Here I have drawn radius 6 cm. Now we have been asked in the question that from a point 10 cm away from its center. Here this is 6 cm distance. So let us take 4 cm more on either of the sides. Here you can see that I have taken 4 cm extra. Okay. So this complete distance must be equal to 10 cm. So let this point be P, and I am going to join this point P with the center point. Now children, you can see that this is rest part 4 cm and the complete is 10 cm. Children, always remember, whenever you have been asked to draw two tangents from an external point, then that external point must be joined with the center point. After that, we are just going to draw the bisector of this line OP. You know how to draw the bisector of the line OP? Definitely you are supposed to take more than half of the length of OP. You are supposed to open the compass more than half of the length OP. And then you are just going to draw the arc on the upper part as well as on the lower part of the line segment to divide it in two equal parts. So children, here you can see that I have taken more than half of the length OP. And I am just going to draw two arcs from point O as well as from point
पी
विच वुड कट द प्रीवियस टू आर्क्स. ओके नाउ आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू ड्रॉ द बाइसेक्टर ऑफ दिस लाइन सेगमेंट लाइक दिस. फाइन लेट दिस बाइसेक्टर कट दिस लाइन ओपी एट पॉइंट एम. सो लेट दिस बी पॉइंट एम. नाउ चिल्ड्रन व्हाट वुड बी द नेक्स्ट स्टेप व्हाइल मेजरिंग दिस लेंथ दैट इज ओ एम. Or taking M as a center and while measuring the length equal to OM or even you can take MP also, we are just going to draw one dotted circle over here, fine, which would cut the given circle at two points. So children, here you can see that I have just taken the radius equal to OM and while taking M as center point, I am just going to draw one dotted circle. Here you can see that circle is going to touch the center point as well as point P. Here you can see that this dotted circle is going to intersect the given circle at two points. So let them give the name as B as well as C. Now children, from this external point you are just going to draw two tangents, that would be PB as well as PC. See children how I am going to draw the tangent from this point. You can see here B is the point of contact. In the same manner I am going to draw one tangent which would move from point C. Just observe it and understand, this is PC, correct? So you had been given this bigger circle of radius 6 cm and a point P which is external of this circle and it is total 10 cm away from the center point. I have drawn two tangents. Now children, here you can see that point B as well as point C, they both are the point of contact for the tangent PB as well as PC. Now how to justify it? As I have explained you that radius is always perpendicular to the tangent at the point of contact. Now I am going to join O to B because OB will be radius and PB is tangent. So you can see children, from point O to point B I am going to join. Okay, as children now you can observe that this is nothing but the angle in a semicircle, that you know that it is of 90 degree, and it is proved that radius is also perpendicular to the tangent. So it means our tangent is appropriate. Okay, and it is going to satisfy the property also that radius is always perpendicular to the tangent at the point of contact. So how would you justify it? First of all, you will say that angle OBP is equal to 90 degree. Why? Because angle in a semicircle, you can see that it is drawn in a semicircle, fine. So we know that if angle OBP is equal to 90 degree, where OB is radius and PB is tangent, so we can say that radius is perpendicular to the tangent at the point of contact. It means it is sure that PB is the tangent to the circle. One more thing has been asked in the question, that after drawing two tangents, we are just going to measure their length. So children, here you can see that PB as well as PC, they both are of 8 cm, correct? So here you can write, this is of 8 cm, this is also of 8 cm. As we know that the length of the tangents from the external point to the same circle are always equal. So let us do its justification. Here you can see that angle OBP is equal to 90 degree. Reason you know that this is an angle in a semicircle. Angle in semicircle. Okay. So what does it imply? It implies that OB is perpendicular to PB. OB is perpendicular to PB. What is OB here? Here, OB is radius of the circle. If OB is the radius of the circle, so this is damn sure that PB has to be the tangent to the circle. Correct? So, PB has to be the tangent to the circle. Children, in the same manner, while joining O to C, again, OCP will be of 90 degree because angle in a semicircle, as OC is radius, so PC has to be the tangent. Okay? So, this is the justification part of this statement carefully. Draw a circle of radius 5 cm. First of all, we are supposed to draw a circle of radius 5 cm. Then we have been asked to construct a pair of tangents on it so that they are inclined at 60 degree. Means both the tangents are going to form 60 degree angle. And after that, we have been asked to measure the length of both the tangents. So children, let us start this question. First of all, we are going to draw a circle of radius 5 cm. So I am just going to measure the length 5 cm using compass so that I can draw a circle of radius 5 cm. So children, let us draw a circle of radius 5 cm. So children, here I have drawn a circle of radius 5 cm. So let us draw the radius, which is 5 cm. So children, as in the question, we have been asked that we are supposed to draw a pair of tangent to this circle of radius 5 cm. Which are inclined to each other at 60 degree angle. Means suppose if I have taken an external point over here. From this external point, if I am going to draw two tangents to this circle, then these two tangents are going to form 60 degree angle between them. Okay. Children, you may be remembering the theorem which we learnt in the chapter number 10, circles. That angle between two tangents drawn from an external point to a circle is always supplementary to the angle subtended by the line segment joining the point of contact at the center. So children, suppose if I am going to take an external point over here and I am going to draw two tangents and both the tangents are going to draw 60 degree angle. So using this theorem, you can easily understand that the angle at the center must be 120 degree, correct? Because both of these angles must be supplementary, correct? So it means that now I have to draw an angle of 120 degree at the center point. So let us draw what I am supposed to do. First of all, I am just going to draw an arc. Draw the very first arc of 60 degree, okay, and then the another arc will be of 120 degree, correct? So what would be the next step? As I have told you that I am just going to construct the angle of 120 degree at the center point, so just draw it, correct? So this angle is of 120 degree. Fine. So children, as I have told you, suppose if I take an external point over here and from these external points, I am just going to draw two tangents. Okay. So as we know that this is radius OA as well as OB. They both are the radii of the same circle and radius is always perpendicular to the tangent at the point of contact. So what does it implies? That at point A as well as at point B, which both are lying on the circumference of the circle, I am just going to draw two perpendiculars, means right angle on both of these points. So let us start. First of all, draw an arc of any suitable radius of your choice. Okay, at point A Now draw the first arc of 60 degree and another arc will be of 120 degree. Correct? Okay. Now using the same arc, as you know children how to draw a right angle. So I am just going to draw 90 degree. I am just going to go for the angle bisector of 60 and 120. So using it, I am going to get one right angle that is of 90 degree. Correct? In the same manner, I have to draw one 90 degree angle at point B as well. As I know that the length of the tangents, whatever tangents I am going to draw from an external point, they are always perpendicular to the tangent at the point of contact. They are always perpendicular to the radius at the point of contact. So now I am going to draw one right angle at point B as well. Okay. Correct. The first arc will be of 60 degree and another arc will be of 120. Then between 60 and 120 degree, I am just going to construct the angle of 90 degree over here. Let us extend the line segment of the previous angle, which was drawn at point A. This is of 90 degree. This is also of 90 degree. So children, it is sure that this angle must be of 60 degree. How? Because as you know, this is OAB, let it be point C. OACB has become a quadrilateral. As we know that sum of all the four angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degree. Fine. And we know that radius is perpendicular to the tangent. Here also radius is perpendicular to the tangent. This is external point C. Is it given the point external? Let me check once. No, there is no point given. So I have considered it at point as point C. So this is external point. Okay. From point C, what I have done? I have just drawn two tangents, that is CA as well as CB, to this circle of radius 5 centimeters. Understood? For that, what was the procedure adopted? I am repeating. First of all, there is a circle drawn of radius 5 cm. As I know that the angle between two tangents drawn from an external point to the circle is always supplementary to the angle subtended by the line segment. These are the line segments which are joining the point of contact is always supplementary at the center point. Okay. So if I construct an angle of 120 degree over here at the center, so definitely I need to draw 90 degree over here also. So it means this angle, which is inclined or which is made between two tangents, that will be of 60 degree. Correct. So here we can say that both the tangents are inclined to each other at the angle of 60 degree. In justification, what will you write? You will be writing that angle CBO is equal to 90 degree. CAO is also 90 degree. Okay. Angle BOA is of 120 degree. So as we know that PCAO is a quadrilateral and the sum of all the four angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degree. So 90 plus 120 plus 90, that would become 300. When I subtracted it from 360 degree, I have got 60 degree as the angle which is made by both the tangents from the external point. Okay. Now, what else is asked? We have been asked to measure the length of the tangents. Children, as you know that the tangents are always equal in length whenever they are drawn from the external point. Okay. Here you can see that the length of this tangent, that is CA, is 8.5. Let us measure it now. This CB is also equal to 8.5 centimeters. So what else you are supposed to write down? Here you can write that here CA and CB are two tangents drawn from an external point, point C, and they both are inclined to each other at 60 degree. They are inclined to each other at 60 degree. Fine. So now we have just measured the length of both the tangents, that is CA and CB, is equal to 8.5 centimeters. That length must be same, as you know that the length of the tangent drawn from the external point are always equal. Understood? Now children, fifth question was given as homework in the previous lecture. So I am going to switch to solution number 6. The statement of sixth question is, let ABC be a right angled triangle in which AB is equal to 6 cm, BC is equal to 8 cm, angle B is equal to 90 degree. Fine. And BD is perpendicular on side AC from point B. Then through B, C and D, we are supposed to draw one circle and we are supposed to draw the tangent from the external point A to the same circle. So let us start doing what will be the first step, that we are just supposed to draw a right angled triangle ABC. So first of all, let us draw a line segment BC 8 centimeters. So this is line segment BC 8 centimeters. Okay. Now angle B is 90 degree. So let us draw one angle of 90 degree at point B. Construct the first arc of 60 degree, another one of 120. Using the same arc, I am just going to construct 90 degree angle at point B. Correct? This angle is of 90 degree. Now we have been given that AB is 6 centimeter. So let us open the compass of radius equal to 6 centimeter. Fine. While taking B as center, just draw one arc of 6 centimeter. So children, here I have got a point as A. Join this point A to point C. Fine. So this is right angled triangle, right angle at B, where BC is 8 cm and AB is 6 cm constructed. Now next is that BD is perpendicular to hypotenuse AC. Fine, from point B. So children, it means I want point D somewhere on the hypotenuse AC. Fine. So what is to be done for that? You just keep your compass at point B and draw two arcs of any suitable radius which would cut the hypotenuse. Fine. Here you can see that I have got two points. You can just give them the name as P and Q. Fine. Now children, what you are supposed to do, here you can see that we have got a line segment PQ. Now I am just going for the perpendicular bisector of this line segment PQ so that we can get one point D which would lie on the hypotenuse AC, and from there a perpendicular will be drawn. Okay. So for perpendicular bisector, what you are supposed to do, you are supposed to take more than half of the arc of this length PQ. So this I have taken more than half. You can see, draw one arc from point Q and another arc from point P. Which would cut this previous arc. Okay. Now join this point with point B. Okay. So children, here I have got a point, that is point D, on hypotenuse AC such that BD is perpendicular from point B on AC. So I can say that angle BDC is of 90 degree. Understood? Now children, we have been asked that we are just going to draw one circle which would pass from point B, D and C. But we cannot draw the circle until or unless we will be having some center point. So children, if it is said that there should be a circle which should pass from B, D and C, it means, suppose here I am just going to draw the circle. Through this you can easily understand that BC will be the diameter for that circle. Then and only then a circle can be drawn passing from the point B, D and C. Okay. Here BC will be the diameter. Moreover, I know that in a semicircle, the angle subtended in the semicircle is always of 90 degree, which is already with us. So what we are supposed to do? First of all, we need some center point for that. Okay. So that we can draw a circle passing through point B, D and C. As I have told you, then in that case that BC will act like a diameter. So definitely for getting the center point, we are supposed to do the perpendicular bisector of this line segment BC. So let us take more than half of this length so that we can draw the perpendicular bisector. Fine. This is more than half, children, you can see. So while taking B as center point, I have drawn two arcs. And while taking C as center point, I am just going to draw two more arcs, okay, which would cut the previous arc. So children, now I am going to join them. Fine. So through this, I have got one center point. Let it be point M. Okay. So we can say that BM is equal to MC. Now children, we are supposed to draw one circle which would pass from B, D and C. So what is to be done? I must have to take the compass and I have to measure this length which must be equal to BM. And while taking M as center point, I have to draw one circle. Fine. Now I have taken the length equal to BM, that is actually 4 centimeter. So while taking M as center point, I am just going to draw one circle which would pass from point B, D and of course C as well. Semicircle is drawn. Now the next semicircle I am going to draw. Now children, using this diagram you can easily understand that this is a circle, okay, which is going to be passed from point B, D and C. Fine. And here BC is the diameter, as I taught you. and we know that the angle in the semicircle is always of 90 degree, which we already had. Understood? Now, one more thing we are supposed to do in this question, that is, we are supposed to construct the tangent from this external point A to this circle. So, let us recall the steps. Whenever we are supposed to draw the tangent from any external point to this circle, we are just going to join that center point with the external point with the center point. Okay, so let us join A to M. Fine. What will be the next step? We are supposed to take the perpendicular bisector of this line segment AM to come to know about new center point. For perpendicular bisector, you know that we are supposed to take more than half of the length AM. Okay. So, while taking M as center point, I am just going to draw one arc. And while taking M as center, again I am drawing one more arc. Fine. Now, children, while taking A as center point, I am just going to cut the previous two arcs. Clear? Now, let us join both of them. I am just going to make it dark so that you can come to know. So, here I have got one more point. Let it be point O. This is new center point. Fine. I have been asked to draw two tangents from point A to this circle. So, what I am supposed to take, I must have to measure the length either AO or OM. Fine. Then while taking O as center, I will be going to draw one dotted circle. Now, I have measured the length AO and OM. Fine. Now, while taking O as center point, I am just going to draw one dotted circle, which must pass from point M as well. Correct? Here you can see, children, I have drawn one dotted circle. Now, what would be the next step? At what two points this dotted circle has touched the given point, given circle? Here you can mark. Fine, you can give the name as P and P dash. This is P dash or B, that is one and the same thing. Okay, means P dash is coinciding the point B. So now let us draw two tangents from point A to point P and from A to B, which is already drawn. You can see I am just going to darken it. This is first tangent and this would be the another tangent. Correct? So, AP and AP dash, these are two tangents drawn to the given circle. Fine, students? This is not at all tough. Please follow the steps whatever I have taught you in this video. You will definitely be able to draw whatever is the demand of the question. In the same manner, you will be able to construct this diagram. So, now children, this is the time to get mathematics homework. So, your maths homework is revise question number 1, which is based on division of a line segment in the given ratio internally of exercise 11.1 and all the 7 questions of exercise 11.2, which are based on the concept of drawing the tangents from the external point to the circle in practice notebook. So, children, that's it for the day. Thank you and have a nice day.